You little beauty! And for Sandra Sully, I want to say happy 30 years at 10. Every time I see her at an awards night, I like it. She just walks up and freaks me out. And just behind me, she'll go, hello, Tom. Sandra, you're freaking me out!
You're here to talk about your new show, Lighten Up.
Yes.
I'm assuming it's based on your award-winning Logie speech where you told us all we need to lighten up.
That's right. Yep. Yeah, I've told people to lighten up and because I want people to come along and they shouldn't take themselves too seriously like some in the industry, Carrie. They took themselves a little too seriously. Mm. But to the detractors to my Gold Logie win, I just want to tell them...
Open it.
Sorry. I want to tell them that I rigged it fair and square.
So the question I want to know is winning a Gold Logie this bit of extra scratch at the box office for your shows?
Well, that's people say that people were offended by my win, but the box office suggests that that's not the case. I've never sold so many tickets. I'm on in Perth this weekend and it's all sold out. I've added an extra show. So the Gold Logie works when it comes to shifting some bloody units.
Well, your new show is called Lighten Up,
yes.
Which some people might see as a bit off brand. For you, we got the poster yes. here, and it's a lovely. I mean, we know why it's called Lighten Up, but this poster, this wasn't the poster I was expecting.
Yeah, well, I got that photo in a beautiful field of flowers there, but I didn't ask permission from the farmer, and
we just drove to a random.
Well,
farm.
I just jumped down. I thought we'll just get the photo.
Is it canola?
Yeah, it's canola. We jumped in the canola field, got the photo, and the farmer drove up and he was really angry. He's like, "Get out of there! What are you doing in my field? You're trampling my crop!" Exactly. And he got really upset with the producer who was looking after the photo shoot had tight black jeans, looked really inner city Melbourne. I said, "Don't talk to him, I'll fix it." And I walked up to the farmer, I said, "I'm so sorry." And he looked at me and he's like, "Oh, that's bloody you." Because it was down the road from where I lived. And he said, "What's it for?" And I said, "It's for a show." And he said, "Well, you should know better, mate." And I said, "Well, it's for a show called Lighten Up, buddy."
So, Tom, fresh from smashing Costa in the Logies, of course, you then referred to the Prime Minister as Australia's relief teacher before the election.
Yeah.
Because I assume you thought he was going to lose.
Well, yeah. And... Well, I wasn't the only one. I mean, PVO predicted.
You thought he was going to lose.
By one or two seats, and he did.
No, during the ad break of the coverage, he said, "There's no way we're going to win." But anyway.
Well, you threw in the towel, and so I believed your prediction.
I didn't throw in the towel, mate.
Yeah, well, you retired, and you thought, well, I thought Christopher Pine's out, so clearly he's got no chance, and I thought he was like Australia's relief teacher. But it turns out he was like Australia's relief teacher that got offered a permanent position.
That's very rare these days.
Yeah, and everyone thought, I don't know who made that decision, but it's been made, so we'll just make the most of it. And we thought the best of him, and then we've worked out he's the worst teacher that we've ever had. Because during Year 12 exams, when we really needed him, he nicked off overseas.
Unlike other comedians, you actually encourage heckling in your shows. That's right.
Well, I do, yeah. So if anyone wants to come along to my show, the good news is if you hate my guts, for the small price of I don't know how much the ticket costs, maybe $45, you can turn up and just rip into me and I don't care.
So Morrison can turn up and just let loose.
Well, he can, but unfortunately he might turn up with a few quiet Australians and I'm guessing they don't heckle.
Or Mr. G could turn up.
Oh, really?
You also have a little fact-checking thing at the end of the show, which is nice.
Yeah, that's right. I always like to... I invite the audience to tell me what they didn't believe in the show and then I come clean on what actually happened and I always correct it, which is very nice. And I did a show recently and I asked the audience what they didn't believe and they said, "We didn't believe it at the beginning of the show when you said that you're glad to be here." Well, and I'm like, "You're right, this is a shithole." Well done, well spotted.
We've loved having you here, believe that. Tom is currently touring Lighten Up around the country. For details, check the links page on our website. Would you please thank Tom Gleeson?
Thank you.
Thank you. Quick break.